I'm back out here now, guys and gals. I had to run in and I was getting a craving for a cup of coffee, even though it's 10 o'clock at night. I said I'm off tomorrow, so I'm not worried about getting to bed at no certain time. It's just them little folders, tea bag like coffee bags that I use when I'm out and about. They're good. Before I shift gears into something else, I was talking a minute ago about how I wasn't a doomsdayer, prepper, all that. And I'll never ever try to predict when Christ is going to come back. Like I said, the word says not even angels in heaven know. But I do want to read something here and to see if it sounds familiar to anybody. See if you know of or ever heard of anyone like this. It's from 2 Timothy chapter 3, and it starts on verse 1. It says, "This know also." Now, this is Paul talking to Timothy, but it goes for us. "This know also that in the last days perilous times shall come." Now this is what I want you to listen, see if you recognize any of this. "For men shall be lovers of their own selves." Yep. "Covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent." That doesn't mean bladder control. It means able to control themselves against the urges they have. "Fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof." And advice here, "From such as these turn away. For of this sort are they which creep into houses and lead captive silly women laden with sins, led away with divers or various lusts, ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth." Now that's not a down, speaking down against women. Talking about the type of people that would come and deceive women at those times. Unmarried women, widow women. Kind of like you hear all the scams on widows and the elderly and stuff. But those things, guys, if you don't know someone who has one of those traits, or you yourself doesn't have one of those traits, at least at one time in your life, then you've been in a coma, or under a rock, or living in a cave, or something. "Men should be lovers of themselves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection." Not going to get into that. That's not hard to figure out what he's talking about. "Truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good." How many times you hear about somebody trying to do something good, and somebody comes in and takes them out? Missionaries getting shot, killed, strung up in some of these third world countries. Churches getting burned down. It's people trying to do good. Now granted, we're all human. Some of them may not be doing it in the right way. But it's still people with the intent of doing good, and people just come and take it out. It's very uncanny how those words describe, well, what we see every day. Okay, now, I feel a little better. I'm not a depressed y'all. feel better after getting some of that off my chest. We'll try to get this lid off of here without turning everything over. And a little light would help. It's not going to be easy. Toothpick reached down in here and stirred around. And what I've got in here is about done what it's going to do. It's about time to clean it out. And what's left in here is not junk or trash. It's good stuff too. It's for a totally different purpose. Get into that shortly. I said I've got another video on this, guys. A little more detail and such. And I was actually doing it over a fire. When I was in there making my coffee, me and Trevor were just talking about that. He said, why is it taking so long? I can't regulate my heat. So I had to put all this stuff in between it. And that slows down the heat going to it. Over a big fire, y'all seen the horseshoe thing that I have. I can set my tin on it as close or far away from the flame and the main source of heat as I want. Here I just got to go with what it's got, but it works. And I'm in no hurry to sit down here killing time. It's not cold at all. I was reading off my phone a Bible app called YouVersion, which is very good if anybody's interested. YouVersion. It's free. It's got 30, 40 translations of the Bible. You can sign up for daily reading plans. Take notes on it. Bookmark it. 90% of the time when I post something on Facebook, scripture, I copy and paste it from there. Got a lot of capabilities to it. It's all free. It's very good. This is the one I had in my pocket. It's called the Sportsman's Bible. King James Version. I'll probably do a little more talking about it on another video here coming up. In the back, it's got a small concordance, not really in depth. But it also has articles on the outdoors and devotional type things relating outdoors with scripture, which I really like. That's what we're here for most of the time. Switching gears, let's see, what can we do to not talk about things that have made us mad the last couple of days? Christmas is coming up. Hope everybody is able to get with their families and enjoy that. I don't know where y'all live. Well, I do know where some of you live. Doesn't look like here in Southwest Virginia there's going to be a white Christmas. It's going to be a wet Christmas, I believe. Maybe even a cool one, not a white one. Let's see. What else is going on? We're in between hunting seasons here right now. Late muzzleloading getting ready to come in. Squirrel season's still in. Nobody making fun of my Crocs. Just for around the house use only. And are camouflaged, so that makes me a little bit less girly in them. Let's see. I know 90% of y'all already turned this off, and I don't blame you. I believe I would have to. I may end up not even posting it, I don't know. Smokey. Smokey, come here. Don't knock the camera over. And my good boy Mokey. And my good boy Mokey. Alright, get down. get in. I gotta talk about something else because I'm getting ready to take that load of pitch out of there, and I want to show y'all that what's left over and stuff. These little sterno cans. I got a doggy. Very handy for things like this. This is the one that actually has liquid fuel in it instead of it being gel. It burns a lot hotter than the gel ones. They're cheap, guys. You can get them 75 cents a dollar a can. They burn anywhere from 2 to 6 hours according to what you get. But stuff like this, or making char cloth, or, you know, when you can't really get out, or you just don't feel like getting out, but you have a couple of projects you want to fool with, that's perfect. If you're wanting to make hooks or something, you know, just to have it ready to throw in your pack, and you're going to use the pine pitch as a binding agent, perfect way to melt it down from a solid state. It's just real handy and cheap, and I like cheap. Don't we, old boy? Don't we, old boy? Hop down. Watch out of the way. You can't have my coffee. When I pull this stuff out, I'm just gonna put it on a regular paper towel until it hardens up. Works for me, as long as you don't land on my foot. All right, go ahead and take this off. No way, boy. It's hot. Oop. There might still be a little dripping, so make sure you shake it out of there. I'm gonna go ahead and take that off there, too. Basic $1 sink stop of that. Works wonderfully well, wonderfully well. Alright. It's smoking a little and aggravating me, so I won't pop the lid back on it. Parsley. Alright, to get this stuff out of here, so we grab that lid, or tin, my pliers, it's getting hot. I've got this screw drilled down in there just to keep it up off the bottom of the tin it was melting into. I'm sure it's hot as well. Not too bad. Then I can back it out. Just take this toothpick. And scrape the old junk out of there. I'll show you what it looks like. Actually, this little cheap knife blade here is already covering the pitch. I'm going to use it instead. We're back on here, guys. Made up to the camera I made to go to show you what that stuff looked like that I took out of the tin after it's been rendered, and realized that I was out of space on the memory card. So we'll try it again. We'll stick it on this knife. The white that you see on it is where I laid it on that paper towel. But you talk about a great cold extender. I haven't really had any luck getting it to take flame or take a spark from a ferro rod. But I'm gonna leave it on that knife there and just show you how long it'll burn. And it will burn quite a while. Changed my method out here and rendering this other down. Mainly just because I'm getting bored. Look at that, man. Some kind of flame. So I'm just taking this raw stuff. Putting it in my tin with the holes in it. And just letting it burn like a lantern. Dripping down in one of the lids, and then I dump it out. Without a doubt, wasting some of it. Like I said, I'm a little bored. And it's just something to do. I do have this tin of the dried stuff I was going to show you. Things happen. Things happen. Oh, well. If I could get some of that out that broke up. Be set up hard enough yet. It's not really a cold out here tonight. If you're doing this on a cold night or day, it sets up almost instantly as soon as you remove it from the flame. This is a piece of it dried after it's rendered. Don't know how much you can tell there, but it kind of has the same color and even texture as a piece of broken beer bottle. I don't know about napping, if it's hard enough for that, but you can get a pretty sharp edge on it if need be. I just let that burn in there. Every now and again I'll pick it up. Set it on this other lid. Take one run out. Warm it back up. Because it does cool off. Maybe not solid, but gummy pretty quick. Warm it back up. Dump it into my tin of pure stuff. Just something fun to mess with out here, guys, and it'll already be done for me when I need it. Need be, if you're in a place that has an abundance of it and you're out camping or whatever, that's what's burning in there now is a chunk, maybe that big around, about big as a silver dollar, and it burned for a pretty good while. So if you're in a place that has an abundance of it, you could use it as a lamp, torch or whatever. I saw a video of somebody using it as the fuel for their torch. I believe it was Trapper Jack. Which he was in a place that had a lot of it. Still raining. Almost talked myself into sleeping out here. Feels pretty good. Well, guess I've bored y'all long enough. Having a real good time checking the Facebook post about what I was doing here, for those of y'all that saw it. Either on a lot of my Path Outdoors or Wolf Custom page, I just put a picture of that little setup. Put something like, guess what I'm doing now, or what I'm up to now, or something. Travis, I know you're watching. Having a little trouble figuring it out, and the hoss said, think outside the box. Travis said, I don't even see a box. That was my giggle for the evening. Oh, before I go, no, I'll save that for another time. Make you curious. And like I said, I bored y'all enough. I'm gonna jump off here. We'll try to get. I've got some ideas, a couple of things I'd like to do on vid, and it's like I said, it's supposed to rain all day tomorrow, but I could do some of them just sitting here. A couple of devotionals I've got on my mind. I've been doing a study series that I just felt that I needed to do, maybe share, and it's helped me a lot going through it about things that we need to do daily to continue to grow in our walk with Christ. It's no big revelation. It's common things that everybody knows already, but just doing a little studying into it. Thought I'd share it. So we might try to get that knocked out tomorrow. Got a couple more devotional ideas. And a couple more small little projects that I believe I can handle here. So thank y'all for watching, putting up with me. Check us out. If you got a Facebook, look for Light Into My Path Outdoors. Started in about the same time as I started this channel, for those that don't know. And it's a place just to share scriptures, talk about anything that has to do with outdoors, hunting, fishing, gardening, bushcraft, it don't matter. Share your pictures. Stories. Like I said, it's a place for scripture, biblical discussion, prayer requests, whatever you feel like. I'm going to throw this out there too. Check out Wolf Customs. A buddy of mine, Justin Wolf from Kansas. Very good group. Very good group of guys. It's hard to say I met somebody when you've never met them face to face, but you can get to know some people with common interests by the things that we share on there. It's mostly a bushcraft page, but he's open for anything. Check him out. It's a nice group. Sure he'd love to have you, just as we would in Light Into My Path Outdoors. So I'm going to jump off here. We'll see you again before Christmas, but in case you don't see us, wishing everybody a Merry Christmas. Hope you get to spend time with your families. And get out and do something. Even if it's just like this, just get out of the house, breathe some fresh air, and some burning turpentine like I have been. It'll be worth your while, I promise you. Thanks again for watching. Y'all have a good one. God bless.